Now we go to fundamental problem 6.2. Okay, we have this truss members AD, DC, AC, AB and BC. Okay, and then you know that this distance between B and A is a vertical distance of 3 meter, and between D and A is horizontal distance of 2 meter, which is this is 2. Okay, if you draw from C to the line, it is vertical line, and this 2 and 2 meter. Okay, and you have a vertical load downwards of 30 kilonewton is applied at joint D. Okay, and at joint B you have a pin support, and at joint A you have a pin and roller support. Right, so the question asks you again to find what are the forces for each member, and what is the force for each member, and state whether it's intentional compression. Right, so here you can start with anything. I mean, you can find the free body diagram for the hole. For instance, here you have want to find what is the bx and by, and here you want to find what is the ay. Okay, ax, because the normal now is this, right? Ax doesn't matter, it's okay. But here, if you understand this, actually you can simply start with two joints which are obvious that you can find the force members directly. Okay, the first one is joint C, and the other one is joint D. Okay, let's start with joint D. I mean, you can start with joint C, by the way, doesn't matter. So for instance, if you start with joint D, okay, at joint D, what do you have at joint D? You have the vertical load of 30 kN. What else? You have this FDA, right, and FDC, okay? So which direction? So for instance, FDC, FCD, tension, okay? FAD, compression. Okay, how do I know FCD and FCD is tension, FAD is compression? Depends on your understanding. I mean, the level of your understanding, okay? The reason is because from here, let me tell you, 30 Newton, I mean, you have only these two members, right? At this point, 30 kN going down, okay? This FAD is horizontal. It doesn't oppose this 30 kN. Understand that? So this 30 kN will only oppose by FCD, which must go up. As simple as that. Otherwise, it won't be a static equilibrium. Okay? And because of FCD going up, I mean slightly up, okay? I mean the one component is up. So this FAD will go to the left, because this FCD, the X component of it, it goes to the right. So FAD must go to the left. But again, if you are unsure, everything, just assume everything as tension first, and then you see whether you got tension positive or negative. If it is positive, then it is tension. If it is negative, it is compression. If you assume everything as tension first, okay? I mean, here you can do FAD going out, which means that you assume as tension. But later on, you get definitely minus if you do that. Alright? So, here you, okay, by the way, FAD is horizontal, so that's why this X, this Y. But how about FCD? What is the direction, this direction? What about this direction? So how about the direction of this FCD? Okay, direction is collinear, right? So this is 3, this is 4, as simple as that. So this is 3, this is 4, this is 5. 3, 4, 5, isn't it? Okay. Now you can do this FY equals to 0. You do FY equals to 0. What do you have? You have minus 30 kN going down plus FCD times what? The Y component. It is 3 over 5 equals to 0. So your FCD is 50 kN. You got plus 50 kN, which means that it's correct. It is tension. It is, I mean, the direction is the same that you assume, correct as you assume. Okay, so tension, and then you do fx equal to 0. All right. So your fx, you have this minus FAD.
okay, plus FCD, which is 50, and the x component is 4 over 5, isn't it?
Goes to 0.
So your FAD, again, you got you got positive. Hmm? In this case, you got positive, so your FAD is
40 kN. Okay, and then this conversion. Okay,
that's why I say, if let's say you are unsure, you assume this FAD going out extension, right? If you do that, you will have this plus, so you will get minus here. Hmm? If that's the case, so what happened is that now you know that actually it goes inside, and it goes the other way around, which means that it is compression.
Right.
As long as you understand, that's fine. But you need to state that you understand whether it's tension or compression and what is the magnitude. Okay? Now you have this and this, right? What's left? This and that, right? So next, actually you can do some point C. So at joint C, how many members? FCD, okay, CD, BC and CA. Again, you see that this CD and CB, they are collinear, right? On the same line. So actually the third member is a zero force member. So first thing first, you know that actually your FAC is zero. FAC is a zero force member, it is zero. Right? Sorry, FAC. And you know that because from previous, you got your FCD as 50 kN. Tension. So if you do equilibrium, you will have your FBC as the same 50 kN load, okay, in the same tension mode, okay, same. If you do the summation of forces, you will get this answer, right? So FBC is 50 kN tension, same as FCD of 50 kN tension. Right, so you got this. Okay, what's that? This one, which is FAB. Alright? So, next, FAB. You can choose joint A, okay, to find this FAB. So you choose at joint A. Okay, at joint A, what do you have? You don't have this FAC because it's zero force member, okay? But you have this FAD, which is in compression, which means that it goes inside 50. You guys got this. Point A, FAD, 40 kN compression, so it goes inside for this point A. Okay? Compress. AC, you don't have it because it's a zero force member, and you have this FAB, right? Which is basically, let me write that, you know? You have this FAB, alright, and what else? You have the reaction, right, of point A, because of the pin roller, so you just have this direction, which is AX direction, okay? Of course, you should find AX first, I mean, generally speaking, but here, you can see that actually AX equals to 40 kN, as simple as that. If your FX goes 0, and actually here your FAB is 0. Okay, your FAB is 0. Why? Because if you do FY equals to 0, you will get this FAB only in the equation, and that's it. Okay, there's no good.